Welcome to Randy's office. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to complete the pause and practice projects using a sim book. So the first thing you'll want to do is navigate to SimNet, and you can either do that from your LMS, Canvas, D2L, Blackboard, whatever you use, or log in directly to SimNet. And you want to go and open up the sim book. So I'm going to go here and open up chapter one and open the sim book. And the table of contents displays all the different sections in that sim book. And the pause and practice projects are every 2 to 3 student learning outcomes. There's typically 3 to 5 pause and practice projects per chapter. If you're using a Mac, we do have separate instructions for Mac, so you can contact your instructor about that and get the Mac instructions, because these are Windows instructions. But you'll go to the first pause and practice project. What you'll want to do is download the start file. Most projects have a start file. Some of the projects will have additional files, and they'll be linked to the project. So you can click on where it says files needed and open up that student data file and save that. The student data files are also available in the library in SimNet, and also your instructors would have those available for you. So you do that first, and then make sure you open that student data file in the desktop application of whichever Office application you're using, Word, Excel, Access, PowerPoint. Don't use the Office Online versions, because those are scaled down versions of Office and don't have all the features that you'll need to complete the project. So you'll just follow the instructions working in the live desktop application. It'll have you name it a specific name and follow all the instructions. There's plenty of screenshots available and very detailed instructions. There's a screenshot at the end of what your project should look like. Once you finish your project, go ahead and save that, and then you can return to the sim book and move on to the next pause and practice project. You can click the table of contents button and move on to the next one, and you'll continue on, and you'll see it'll have you open the file that you previously worked on and rename it with a different name and then continue on. And you'll do that for all the pause and practice projects in the chapter. This particular chapter has 4. So after I finish 2, I would go on to 3, and then I would go on to pause and practice 4. Again, it's going to have me open up the previous file I used and rename it, and then continue on doing all the instructions. And as you get to the end, you can compare yours with the solution screenshot at the end. And once you finish that final project, you go ahead and save it, and then your instructor will tell you how to submit these files. You may upload them to your LMS. He or she may have you email them those files, but just make sure you read the instructions from your instructor as to how to submit those files. These projects are not auto-graded in SimNet like the SimNet projects are, so you will turn them into your instructor. I hope this information helps, and have a wonderful day.